here with a wall of text on the screen. I killed her directly. Killed her with my own indirect actions. She's dead now, and I'm alive. I'm still here, lying on the bathroom floor. On the 14th story of Shinjuku's Tenmujin's office building. And I have a point underneath my fingernails that the alley is going to start work in here on Monday. But I did it. I killed her finally. After countless months of pretensing, of false starts, of failures, and disappointments, I killed somebody again. Corpse Girl strikes for a second time. Above all else, above this grim and muck on the floor, and this tingling feeling underneath my fingernails, above all of that, this feels good. And this feels so, so good. Blood has returned to my legs, and the pins and needles have faded, and my toes quiver beneath my stocking and shoes. An electrical charge pulls down my thighs and dissipates through my feet. I manage to plant 2 feet firmly on the tiles and push myself into my wobbly knees. I suck in the air and breathe all of it. All of my back out almost at once. I feel dizzy and a bizarre warmth is welling inside my stomach and chest. I managed to steady myself enough to sit back on the top of the toilet seat with my feet planted firmly on the ground and my hands resting on my lap. I try to regain my sense of self. I might have lost my composure a little bit upon reading the news, but who could blame me? Everything I've worked for over the last year is finally starting to pay off. My second victim is dead, with Corpse Girls probably sure to rise. Heh. That makes it amusing. More and more people will issue requests through my website. More and more people will receive corpse photos. And more people will... She killed herself. She killed herself? How I wish I could see the real body. If only I could see her mangled corpse. Drenched in sweat and finally in peace. I noticed my phone is wedged between my fingers. I must have subconsciously scooped it up from the pool of muck on the floor. I try to ignore the sticky texture clinging to my screen. Okay, my fingers are no longer numb. I scroll and reread the obligatory article. Miss Akane Tsutsumaki, 36, of Chuba Prefecture was pronounced dead this morning. Dead. Pronounced dead. Oh, yes! Keep on bringing it up that she's dead! My breathing staggers once again. My jaw generally lowers. Actually, gently lowers. Invalid and accidental. Hot, steamy clouds up my face. Resulting in my self-asphyxiation. I salivate unconsciously, and trickle of moisture creeping down my chin, and dripping on my lap. My cheeks are flushed, my vision slightly blurred. She killed herself because of me. Okay. Yes, we know. I let out a gasp as my lips raise against the wall of my toe. As it will. My toes curl. My legs stiffen. My skin tingles. I lean back against the crystalline and cold porcelain. It goes a different word, but I'm gonna skip it. The thin fabric of my clothing and chilling my burning hot skin. My eyelids flutter as my mind hazes over. I can't control my body any longer. All the anticipation of the last few days and tension building in my muscles. I can't. My legs tense up, my knees buckle, my neck tilts back. A whispering gasp slips softly between my lips. My phone falls to the ground once more as my fingers slowly uncurl. The dull, thin sound as it hits the floor is the last thing my foggy mind registers before I drift away. Shit. Tome's frazzled brawl snapped me out of my dead-eyed stare. Welcome back to insults. I don't know what she's talking about. I can't really focus on what she's saying. I realized I've been staring at my computer screen for about 20 minutes, rarely blinking. My mouth is dry, as though I've stopped producing saliva altogether. A dull throb on my lap ceases me to cross my legs over the other in an attempt to get comfortable. Really? I'm getting my fucking job done. I don't care what you trying to tell me. I got a job to do. I swallow in an attempt to moisten my parched throat before speaking in a choked voice, in a cracked voice. Shit. Okay, time to go back to the cat fight. Please go on. I want to be entertained more. And if you animate it, hell yeah! I can tell Tomei is trying to get under my skin, but I'm honestly not in the mood to deal with it right now. What, are you planning to go for round two? I realize my voice is louder than intended. A few people nearby tilt their heads quizzically. Tomei takes a cautious step back. You expect me to do the whole Karen thing? Like, come on! My question is, why the fuck didn't you? You wanna go for round two? There's witnesses, we can give them a show! I will win! It's a whole no holds bar match, bitch. We all know what will happen. Either way, I'll be amused. Unless they actually go with like a freaking main character dies. In that case, fuck. Less of a story, shit. Lost for words. Tomei turns tail and walks away. I sigh and lean back in my office chair. Why do I feel so exhausted? My mind flickers, piecing through fragments of my memory from the bathroom a short while ago. That's right, I let myself get carried away in the exhaustion of my success. I temporarily step away from my own body and let my base instincts take over. But I'm in control now. I'm myself again. That's always the best part. I'm Noriko, stoic and unflinching. I'm Corpse Girl, successful and feared. I can kill people as easily as I can manipulate a photo. People like Tomei should be scared of me. People like Tomei shouldn't mess with me. I'm in control now. Are you sure? Climbing up the steps to my apartment is always such a chore. I wish I'd moved into a building with an elevator, but I simply couldn't afford to when I first moved out on my own last year. Those old apartment buildings creaked and groaned when you ascended the stairs. On top of that, you can hear the bustling of other people within their tiny homes as you proceed up each floor. There's always a slight whiff of mold and or mildew wherever I ascend the stairs. Brought to you by mostly life-threatening things like mold, which is... Depending on which one it is, it'd be deadly. Like, holy shit. I want to chuck it up to the fact that the building is old, but it is possible some of the residents here don't keep their apartments very clean. At the very least, this neighborhood is decent. I feel safe in my home, even if it is small and cramped. And the neighbors are respectful, from what I can tell. Not that I really know them at all. Fuck it, you don't need to know them. All they need to know is that somebody lives in that apartment. In fact, only neighbors I have regular contacts with are the very same ones I leech Wi-Fi from. Some middle-aged divorced guy named Kinji, who lives on the floor below me, and his daughter Momo. Kinji's a decent enough guy. He works overnight, which unfortunately means Momo's left home alone, and a lot in the evenings. Momo's a sweet girl, perhaps 6 or 7 years old. Occasionally, I hear her singing, drift up into my apartment, but it doesn't bother me too much. She's just a kid. Well, what is he supposed to do? I don't think there's a lot he can do, because, well, best he can do is like what? Let his kid go to daycare during the day and then he sleeps? No, I don't think a lot of daycare places stay up all night. Like, come on. It's the very same Kenji and Momo I bumped into when I was climbing the stairs this evening. Cool, we get to see who he is. At least he's trying to keep an eye on people. That's always good. I tilt my head and reach a hand on my cheek. Sure enough, dry mulch, muck is blend into my makeup and cracked and caked on my face. It seems like the eyeliner has smeared as well. Is this from when I fell in the bathroom? Damn it! Have I looked like this the all day? I'm gonna show it like goddamn! I try to make up some lies so Kenji doesn't worry about me. Aw, at least the kid's twying. I can't help but smile slightly at Momo's generous offer. The girl nods, resolutely. Yeah, she works with the data. That's all you need. I blink a couple of times. It's not like I talk to this guy often. Really, we hardly know each other. Still, I've never heard him actually mention Momo's mom before. Most of the things I know about him, I've just pieced together from contacts. Huh. At least he's doing what he can, man. Cool. Security, of course. Now, of course. Now I remember. He did mention when we first met what he does for a living. If memory serves, he works for a private security company. I assume he guards corporate offices or parking lots, something like that. It works. The girl blushes and hides behind her dad. And from here, I think it's the best time to kind of end the episode. This one went a little long. So, I hope you guys have a great, love time, great day too, and I'm gonna question what the fuck I'm gonna do.